Welcome back, folks. I'm MTG Joe. So something I wanted to do, we did this a bit when we were looking at rotation proof decks, are some quick deck techs. So I'm going to do this on Pioneer. I've been mostly playing Pioneer in paper. But one thing we do a lot on the channel is budget decks. And one thing I want to highlight, we'll do a couple budget decks in Pioneer. So this first one up is a $47, so under 50 bucks. It is a mono red devotion deck. So the goal of this deck is to get a bunch of permanents out with red symbols and their converted mana cost, and then play Fanatic Amogus. So when it enters the battlefield, it deals damage to each opponent equal to your devotion to red. So what devotion is the number of colors. So for example, Goblin Chain Whirler has a devotion of 3. So what we're trying to do with the deck is kind of a mono red, red deck wins kind of approach, smash into your opponent and then deal a lot of damage that way. So to kind of walk you through the deck, in the one drop slot, we have Fanatical Firebrand. So one of the staples of the past red deck wins. It's a hasty 1-1, and it can deal 1 damage to player or creature when you can sack it, so it can help you trade up. We also have 4 copies of Rakdos Cackler. So this is a hybrid, but it does count as red mana. So it has the ability Unleash. So you can have it enter the battlefield with a 1-1 counter on it, and then it doesn't block. So it's effectively a 1-mana 2-2 in red. We have 3 copies of Shock. You can play Wild Slash if you have them, but they're a couple bucks, so you might as well just play Shock. 2 copies of Ash Zealot. It's one of the budgety 2-drops. So it's a 2-mana 2-2 for Strike Haste. So comes down, turns it sideways, deal damage. Its second bit of text, I don't see any particular use for it right now. So whenever an opponent casts a spell from their graveyard, it deals 3 damage to that player. There's not really many flashback effects in the current standard. So it's really like mission briefing, that would be it. But this was really good in past Ravnica standard when flashback mechanic itself was a thing. Then there's 4 copies of Burning Tree Emissary. If you could get multiples of these in your opening hand, you can chain them together, so it's just a lot of devotion. The one thing I did want to add was a 2-drop at least that you can also cascade or kind of chain into. Because it adds the green mana, we can't really play, say, an Ash Zealot or 2 1-drops. So I'm playing 4 copies of Runaway Steamkin. Runaway Steamkin can let us get these explosive draws where we chain together a bunch of red spells. It can also just then in turn become a 2-mana 4-4, which is pretty big. It also helps us ramp. So we have Steamkin. Our 3-drop slot, we have 4 copies of Boros Reckoner. This at one point was I think close to $40 card in standard. It was one of the premier kind of mid-range aggro threats. So whenever Boros Reckoner is dealt damage, it deals that much damage to target creature or player. So it's basically, if it takes a bunch of damage, you can throw it back at the opponent. If like a Nissa land attacks it, it could kill the land and throw damage. But also for 1 red mana, it could gain first strike till the end of turn. And then we got Whirly Boy, Goblin Chain Whirler. Most of you are probably familiar if you played standard. First strike 3-3. So a lot of the theme, we got first strike a lot in here, which helps us trade well. And then when it enters the battlefield, deals 1 damage to each creature the opponent controls and each opponent. This is very good against all these green based decks that go wide with like elves. Our 4-drop slot, we have Chandra, Fire Artisan. So this would likely become the other 4-mana Chandra. But for now, it's just card advantage in the deck. If we spew our hand, we can gain some card advantage. When it deals damage, it's taken damage, we can redirect that damage. And it's also 2 points of devotion. 2 copies of Experimental Frenzy. If we can get it going with Steamkins, it's a lot of value off the top. The 4 copies of Mogus, as we highlighted, and 2 copies of Torbran. So it just makes all our red sources deal 2 more damage. Then in terms of the mana base, we have 2 Castle Umbrance, just a mana sink to make our team bigger, especially with the first strike, it's quite relevant, and then 20 mountains, so 22 lands total. And then the sideboard, we have a couple of Braids versus artifacts or just damage, some Fries versus blue-white stuff, Lava Coils versus creature decks, especially with all these mono-black aggro decks coming around, the Exile is quite relevant. Some Spyglasses, you can name like Planeswalkers, lands, Copters, stuff like that. Some Tybalts versus the life gain decks. This would be like Marauding Raptor instead if you're not playing on a budget. This sweet tech is Burning Earth, so whenever a player taps a non-basic land for mana, Burning Earth deals one damage to that player. Nexus, they can't actually combo out because they'll burn themselves out. You can bring it in against like three color decks, stuff like that. It's a way to get some residual damage and just put attacks on the opponent. When I was playing Control a lot back in Ravnica block, I had a very hard time as Esper Control. I try to tap out for Sphinx's Revelation and take a bunch of damage. And then two more copies of Frenzy versus the grindier matchups. So really what you can do is if you have like Eidolon of the Great Revel, that's a really good two drop. Like I said, Chandra, four mana Chandra, you can put in there. Chandra Acolyte of Flame even as a three mana spell. So those are all good additions that you can play in the deck itself. Light Up the Stage can be a potential option as well. But for under $50, it seems like a pretty solid deck. Probably going to throw it together in paper to see as kind of a quick deck when I'm not playing my Fires deck. But let me know what you think, if there's any suggestions, any recommendations that you'd make to the deck. In general, if you enjoy this type of content, and if there's any other budget decks you'd like to see in Pioneer, do let me know in the comments below. Just kind of doing this as a feeler to see if it's something useful. I'll put the deck list for export in the video description down below, but you can find all my decks on aetherhub.com. Thanks for tuning in, and have a great one.